theory for the average non-scientist means something very different from what it means for a scientist. What we mean in modern parlance would be, I've got a hunch, I've got a guess, I've got, you know, something like that. Don't really have facts to support that, my idea, but that's my, you know, I've got a hunch about that. That is not what scientists mean when they use the word theory. Let's think about gravity. I think we'd all agree that gravity exists. If I raise an object and then I drop it, that object's going to fall. Why? Because through repeated observations, we've shown that gravitational attraction is a fact. Now, gravitational theory is something different, right? Isaac Newton had a theory about how gravity works. Albert Einstein has a theory about how gravity works that encompasses Newton's ideas. It's a bigger one. And so the explanation for how gravity works, that's a theory. It's a very broadly encompassing set of inferences that explains the facts. And not only that, it makes new predictions that can be tested. So when people use the phrase evolutionary theory, they're not disputing that evolution has occurred. In fact, the evidence that evolution has occurred is overwhelming. The theory of evolution has to do with how does that evolutionary change occur over time? What are the mechanisms that explain evolutionary theory? And that's where Darwin proposed a theory of evolution by natural selection. Now, that's been augmented with our understanding of genetics. So genetics comes into play, something Darwin didn't really know about. So when we use the word theory, it doesn't mean a hunch, something we wish were true, something like that. No, it's something so compelling that it is the dominant paradigm by which we understand lots of biological phenomena.